Apple just released iPadOS 16.2, which enables a lot of great features, including the ability to use your iPad on a secondary display. But let's be honest with each other, there are still a ton of things missing from iPadOS. And here are 10 things that you'll be surprised that the iPad still cannot do in iPadOS 16.2. Let's get started. Starting with number one, it's the ability to play games full screen when you are on a secondary display. Now, I don't know what Apple was thinking about this one, but any game that I have tried to play, doesn't matter if it's Apple Arcade, doesn't matter if it's from a third-party developer, I cannot play a game on my secondary display and actually use it in full screen. Now, I don't think this is a restriction of having a 5K display or a 27-inch display, because I've tried it on a number of different displays. This one, LG Ultrafine 5K, LG Ultrafine 4K, and a 32-inch BenQ 4K display, and none of the games will run at their full screen size. I end up getting something which is about 50% of the screen real estate, which is annoying. Now, good thing is if you use Sony PS Remote Play and you have a secondary display, you can use PS Remote Play and play any of your games on your PlayStation from your iPad in full screen. You don't necessarily get the full screen resolution of the 5K display or the 4K display that you're using, but it's good enough to play. Yeah, I'll say, let's put it that way. Now let's talk about number two. Now, I don't know what Apple's thinking is behind this. It just doesn't make sense to me. Maybe if it makes sense to you, let me know down in the comments below. But if you are using an external display with your iPad and on that external display, you have an app that is running in full screen. If I open up a second app and I want to use that where the primary app or the first app that I had opened, I want to have it in the center of the display, I can't. They always have to be tiled. I cannot have one app in the front foreground and have the other app in the background. It always has to be tiled. And I don't know, but tiled doesn't really make sense all the time. Sometimes I want to be able to use a app just by itself without having the other app behind it. I don't know what Apple's thinking is about that. That is really annoying for me. Let's move on to number three, which is specific to the M2 iPad Pro. Now, I have the M2 iPad Pro here. Now, if you remember, I think it was iPadOS maybe 15.4 or 15.3, where Apple introduced the ability to have kind of dynamic volume rockers, where depending on what the orientation is of the iPad, the volume rockers would do one thing versus in another orientation, they would do something different. Well, in iPadOS 16.2, no matter which orientation that the iPad is in, it does have that behavior, so they're dynamic, but you can't shut it off. It used to be in menu settings and then volume, but that feature is not available on the M2 iPad Pro. I don't know what Apple's thinking. They haven't told us about it. They just kind of took away the feature, and it's super annoying because I don't like that feature at all on this iPad because I only use the iPad in this orientation, and I don't want to press, which would be the right arrow key to turn up the volume, or the left arrow key to turn down the volume. I want it to be the very way that I'm used to using it. So a little bit of annoyance there with that device. Let's move on to number four. I know a lot of people out there are using their iPad for the day-to-day, their work activities, they're streaming, they're talking to their family via FaceTime. And number four really has to do with the ability to use the webcam that you might have either integrated into your display, like I have on my studio display and that FaceTime camera, or maybe you even have a third-party camera that is connected to your display and you might route it through a Thunderbolt dock. Well, you still cannot use a third-party camera, even the FaceTime camera that's in the studio display, as your primary FaceTime camera. Every time you open up the FaceTime camera on the iPad, you get that really, again, that weird view where it's on that left-hand side. If you have the new iPad 10th generation where it's built in the center of the display, it's a little bit better, but the camera's still not that great. Having the camera here in the top of the center of it would make so much sense, but you can't select it as an output. I would really like to see Apple allow me to choose which camera I have, especially when it's connected to the display on here. So I want to see Apple bring continuity camera from the Mac to the iPad and allow me to use my iPhone as a camera when I want to, right? Why can't I do that? It's available on the Mac, which makes it seem really silly. I don't know. Apple, tell me what you're thinking out there, because it doesn't make sense to a lot of us. Now let's talk about number five. This is going to surprise you because I didn't even know this was available in iOS 16. But if I take my iPhone and I say reboot iPhone, and it basically says, do you want me to reboot? And it turns off the iPhone. That's awesome. That's such a great feature because now I can reboot my phone without needing to interact with the volume rockers and that kind of crazy reboot pattern that Apple has, volume up, volume down, hit the power button. Anyways, however cool that is, you cannot do it on the iPad, where I think that is where it's ultimately more useful than on the iPhone. At least it is useful on the iPad, not where it shouldn't even be included. What is going on here, Apple? Why isn't it on the iPad? It thinks it would make sense there as well in addition to the iPhone, but I don't know. Apple makes some strange choices sometimes. Now let's talk about number six, and this is another strange choice Apple seemed to made. When you are connecting your iPad to an external display, you want to make sure that that external display has built-in speakers, because anytime that you want to use, listen to audio, listen to a movie, play a game, whatever the case is, the audio is always going to come out of the external display, even if it's a studio display. Now, there's no way of changing the default set of speakers, so I can't say I want to use the iPad speakers instead of the external display speakers. There's no way to change that. Well, you cannot even use AirPlay while you are connected to your external display. So if I wanted to use a better set of HomePods, some HomePod minis for some surround sound, that is not possible. I cannot use those speakers to play any type of content. I actually have to disconnect my iPad from the external display and then use those speakers. It's just like, it's so confusing, some of the choices that they made and why they decided to implement them in the manner that they did. I don't know. I like using my HomePods with my iPad. It does sound good if I'm watching movies, playing games, even that much more immersive. If you use HomePods with your iPad to listen to content or watch content, let me know about that down in the comments below. Number 7 is the ability to update the software version on your studio display. Now, I don't know how many of you are out there buying the studio display for your iPad and to use it with iPadOS 16 extended display. I like it. I think it works good. I'm actually going to do a review on it. So if you want to see that, make sure you click that subscribe button right down there. But thing is, in iPadOS 16.2, you cannot update your software of your studio display. What? Apple, what are you thinking? Why would you tell me to use this display that it's the best quality display for my iPad, but I can't update the software? I have to get a different piece of hardware to update it? That makes no sense. And whoever thought of that feature or thought that feature shouldn't be included, I mean, this is kind of like a day one feature. It should be there because I think people are buying the studio display. They might not even have another computer, which, hey, it makes sense. And that goes on with number 8, which is the ability to control Stage Manager and the ability to use Stage Manager via global shortcut keys, or even controlling them via the Shortcuts app. You know, Command Space S, Command, you know, none of those control keys or modifier keys work where you can control Stage Manager. I always have to pull down from Control Center, then hit the button. It's just really, really annoying. And I wish Apple would have brought that out as kind of a day one feature. If we're using it, we want the ability to turn it on, turn it off without that barrier to, you know, swiping down and turning it on. It might not seem like a lot, but it does prohibit your workflow. And it's kind of a pain in the butt if you just think about it. And that's not what I'm talking about. That's not what I'm looking for at all. Now let's talk about number 9. This is another feature where, why are we not thinking this is a day one feature? It's a must have to launch. If I want to use my iPad with my secondary display, and maybe I just want to not use the primary display on my iPad. I just want to, you know, kind of put it in clamshell mode. Or even if I sleep my display, if I close my iPad, the display still stays lit. Say what? Why is the display saying lit? This is an LCD display. I don't want it to keep lit. I don't want to burn backlight. Don't want to burn energy. That just seems like it's a waste. Like here, it's still on. Hello? Apple, are you there? This is silly. I don't know why they would do this. And that brings me to number 10. Number 10, if I want to control the brightness of two displays, I have my my actual iPad display and the external display, I can control one via Control Center. Okay, that makes sense. I can control the internal iPad display via Control Center. But if I want to control the secondary display, where do you think I gotta go? You gotta go to settings, you gotta go to display, you gotta click on the display, you gotta change the brightness there. Is it exactly what you need to? It's just a real pain in the butt. And I don't know what Apple's thinking. If they're going to bring the feature out and make the feature well-rounded for like external display support, at least give us the ability to change the display brightness of both displays in the same location. Don't make it kludgy. Like, why would you do that? It just doesn't make sense. And it makes using your iPad as kind of your primary work machine just a little bit more cumbersome, where you know, you don't get this great taste, so to speak, of, you know, this is really all it should be. Apple, help me out. I want to know what you guys are doing over there. Please throw us a line, something before iPadOS 17. Guys, thanks for watching my video on 10 things that iPadOS 16.2 still can't do. Let me know what your least favorite feature is down in the comments below. If you have a great feature that I should know about, let me know about that. My name is Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one. Happy holidays, happy new year.